You are the most sexist, immature, nut-brained... I'm embarrassed to be related to you! Ever since Mom died, I've been doing all the work around camp while you've been off playing soldier!
Katara?
I even wash all the clothes! Have you ever smelled your dirty socks? Let me tell you, not pleasant!
Katara, settle down!
No! That's it! I'm done helping you! From now on, you're on your own!
That light came from an incredibly powerful source. It has to be him.
Oh, it's just the celestial light.
We've been down this road before, Prince Zuko. I don't want you to get too excited over nothing. Please sit. Why don't you enjoy a cup of calming jasmine tea?
I don't need any calming tea! I need to capture the Avatar!
Katara, you'll feel better after
you... You happy now? There goes my one chance at becoming a waterbender.
Stop bugging her, Airhead. You need to give girls space when they do their sewing.
What does me being a girl have to do with sewing?
Simple.
Girls are better at fixing pants than guys, and guys are better at hunting and fighting and stuff like that. It's just the natural order of things.
All done with your pants, and look what a great job I did.
Wait, I was just kidding. I can't wear these. Katara, please!
Get out of my way, Pipsqueak!
How dare you call me Pipsqueak, you giant-eared cretin?
What did you call me?
A giant-eared cretin! Look at those things! Do herds of animals use them for shade?
You better back off!
Seriously, back off.
I will not back off! I bet elephants get together and make fun of how large your ears are!
That's it! You're going down!
I'll show you who's boss! Earthbending style!
Sailing into Fire Nation waters. Of all the foolish things you've done in your 16 years, Prince Zuko, this is the most foolish.
I have no choice, Uncle.
Have you completely forgotten that the Fire Lord banished you? What have you got?
I'm chasing the Avatar. My father will understand why I'm returning home.
You give him too much credit. My brother is not the understanding type.
You've changed our course for a stupid lotus tile?
See, you, like most people, underestimate its value. Just give me 10 minutes to check the merchants at this port of call. Hopefully, they'll have the lotus tile in stock and I can get on with my life. I'm lucky to have such an understanding nephew.
I used to kind of look up to pirates, but those guys are terrible.
I know. That's why I took this.
No way.
Isn't it great?
No wonder they were trying to hack us up. You stole their waterbending scroll.
I prefer to think of it as high-risk trading.
Good one, Katara.
Sokka, where do you think they got it? They stole it from a waterbender.
It doesn't matter. You put all of our lives in danger just so you could learn some stupid, fancy splashes.
These are real waterbending forms. You know how crucial it is for Aang to learn waterbending.
Whatever. My boat!
Prince Zuko, you're really going to get a kick out of this. The lotus tile was in my sleeve the whole time!
Why do boys always think someone has to be the leader? I bet you wouldn't be so bossy if you kissed a girl.
I've kissed a girl. You just haven't met her.
Who? Gran-Gran? I've met Gran-Gran.
No, besides Gran-Gran. Look, my instincts tell me we have a better chance of slipping through on foot, and a leader has to trust his instincts.
Okay, we'll try it your way, oh wise leader.
Your boyfriend Jet's a thug.
What? No, he's not.
He's messed up, Katara.
He's not messed up. He's just got a different way of life. A really fun way of life.
He beat and robbed a harmless old man.
I want to hear Jet's side of the story. You know what I think? You're jealous that he's a better warrior and a better leader.
Katara, I'm not jealous of Jet. It's just that my instincts...
Well, my instincts tell me we need to stay here a little longer and help Jet. Come on, Aang.
Sorry, Sokka.
Aren't you forgetting the tarp?
Right, got it.
Sokka, you're supposed to put the tarp on top of the tent. You know, so we don't get rained on.
Ordinarily, you'd be right. But seeing how it's the dry season, you're not. Besides, that tarp makes a pretty warm blanket.
But what if it does rain?
What if it doesn't? Then I would have put the tarp up for nothing.
Ugh, you're infuriating!
Katara, why don't you worry about gathering the firewood? Because that kindling's looking pretty sorry.
Well, if you don't like my firewood...
Fine by me! If you're not gonna do your job...
Okay, I get the grub if you guys get the...
Hey, where's the campfire? And what happened to the tent?
Why don't you ask Miss Know-It-All, Queen of the Twigs?
Oh, yeah? Well, you're Mr. Lazy Bum, King of the... Tents!
Please, Father, I only had the Fire Nation's best interest at heart. I'm sorry I spoke out of turn.
You will fight for your honor.
I meant you no disrespect. I am your loyal son.
Rise and fight, Prince Zuko.
I won't fight you.
You will learn respect, and suffering will be your teacher.
I looked away.
Well, now you got to see for yourselves that fortune-telling is just a big, stupid hoax.
You're just saying that because you're gonna make yourself unhappy your whole life.
That woman is crazy! My life will be calm and happy and joyful! Ow! That doesn't prove anything.
Wow, that's good water.
When did you learn how to do that?
I guess I always knew.
Oh! Well, then thanks for all the first aid over the years. Like when I fell into the greaseberry bramble, and that time I had two fish hooks in my thumb.
Two? He tried to get the first fish hook out with another fish hook.
Oh, and the time that mink snake bit me. Thanks for healing that up. That was great. Really helpful.
Do you think we'll really find airbenders?
You want me to be like you or totally honest?
Are you saying I'm a liar?
I'm saying you're an optimist. Same thing, basically.
You're a princess,
huh?
You know, back in my tribe, I'm kind of like a prince myself.
Prince of what?
A lot of things. Do you mind? I'm trying to have a conversation here.
My apologies, Prince Sokka.
So it looks like I'm gonna be in town for a while. I'm thinking maybe we could do an activity together?
Do an activity?
No.
Very smooth.
Look at these magnificent shells. I'll enjoy these keepsakes for years to come.
We don't need any more useless things. You forget, we have to carry everything ourselves now.
Hello, brother. Uncle.
What are you doing here?
In my country, we exchange a pleasant hello before asking questions. Have you become uncivilized so soon, Zuzu?
Don't call me that!
To what do we owe this honor?
Must be a family trait. Both of you so quick to get to the point.
You heard the princess. Raise the anchors. We're taking the prisoners home.
Your Highness, I...
You lied to me!
Like I've never done that before.
Let's go!
You know, Father blames Uncle for the loss at the North Pole. And he considers you a miserable failure for not finding the Avatar. Why would he want you back home, except to lock you up where you can no longer embarrass him?
Huh?
rare coins for weary travelers?
This is humiliating. We're royalty. These people should be giving us whatever we want.
They will, if you ask nicely. Spare change for a hungry old man.
Aw, here you go.
The coin is appreciated, but not as much as your smile.
How about some entertainment in exchange for a gold piece?
We're not performers.
Not professional, anyway. It's a long, long way to Ba Sing Se, but the girls in the city, they look so pretty.
Come on, we're talking a gold piece here. Let's see some action. Dance!
The lake is so sweet that you really got to meet the girls from Ba Sing Se.
Nothing like a fat man dancing for his dinner. Here you go.
Such a kind man.
My boomerang!
There's no time!
Oh, I see. So there's time to get your scrolls and time to get your staff, but no time for my boomerang?
That's correct.
Oh. This temple and this statue were cut from the same stone. And we know that the statue was built after Qin died.
So if they were built at the same time, that means...
Shh! I want to solve it!
These were her boots? Her feet must have been enormous.
The biggest of any avatar.
Wait a minute. Big feet? Little footprints? There's no way!
Special outfit, hat and pipe, these things mean anything to you?
You're right. I'm sorry. Please.
Uncle, I thought a lot about what you said.
You did? Good, good.
It's helped me realize something. We no longer have anything to gain by traveling together. I need to find my own way.
I know it's probably hard for you to see me this way, but the obedient little helpless blind girl that you think I am just isn't me. I love fighting. I love being an earthbender. And I'm really, really good at it. I know I've kept my life secret from you. But you were keeping me secret from the whole world. You were doing it to protect me. But I'm 12 years old and I've never had a real friend. So now that you see who I really am, I hope it doesn't change the way you feel about me.
Of course it doesn't change the way I feel about you, Toph. It's made me realize something.
It has?
Yes. I've let you have far too much freedom. From now on, you will be cared for and guarded 24 hours a day.
But, Dad!
We are doing this for your own good, Toph.
Please escort the Avatar and his friends out. They are no longer welcome here.
I'm sorry, Toph.
I'm sorry, too. Goodbye, Aang.
What's this?
Mom, can you make Zuko play with us? We need equal teams to play a game.
I am not cartwheeling.
You won't have to. Cartwheeling's not a game. Dum dum.
I don't care. I don't want to play with you.
We are brother and sister. It's important for us to spend time together. Don't you think so, Mom?
Yes, darling. I think it's a good idea to play with your sister. Go on now, just for a little while.
If Uncle doesn't make it back from war, then Dad would be next in line to be Fire Lord, wouldn't he?
Azula, we don't speak that way. It would be awful if Uncle Iroh didn't return. And besides, Fire Lord Azulon is a picture of health.
How would you like it if Cousin Liu Ten wanted Dad to die?
I still think our Dad would make a much better Fire Lord than his royal tea-loving kookiness. Fire Lord Azulon. Can't you just call him Grandfather? He's not exactly the powerful Fire Lord he used to be. Someone will probably end up taking his place soon.
Young lady, not another word. What is wrong with that child?
Father,
You must have realized, as I have, that with Lu Ten gone, Iroh's bloodline has ended. After his son's death, my brother abandoned the siege at Ba Sing Se, and who knows when he will return home. But I am here, Father, and my children are alive.
Say what it is you want.
Father, revoke Iroh's birthright. I am your humble servant, here to serve you and our nation. Use me.
You dare suggest I betray Iroh, my firstborn, directly after the demise of his only beloved son? I think Iroh has suffered enough. But you, your punishment has scarcely begun!
Dad's going to kill you.
Really, he is.
Haha, Azula. Nice try.
Fine, don't believe me, but I heard everything. Grandfather said Dad's punishment should fit his crime.
You must know the pain of losing a firstborn son. By sacrificing your own.
Liar!
I'm only telling you for your own good. I know! Maybe you could find a nice Earth Kingdom family to adopt you.
Stop it! You're lying! Dad would never do that to me.
Your father would never do what to you? What is going on here?
I don't know.
It's time for a talk.
Azula always lies. Azula always lies. Where's Mom?
No one knows. Oh, and last night, Grandpa passed away.
Not funny, Azula. You're sick. And I want my knife back, now.
Who's going to make me? Mom?
Where is she?
Do you really want to fight me?
Yes. I really do.
Zuko!
I was wondering when you'd show up, Zuzu.
Zuzu?
Back off, Azula! He's mine.
I'm not going anywhere.
Could use a little help.
Thanks. Well, look at this. Enemies and traitors all working together. I'm done. I know when I'm beaten. You got me. A princess surrenders with honor.
Zuko, I can help.
Excellent. You've got it.
Great. I'm ready to try with real lightning.
What? Are you crazy? Lightning is very dangerous.
I thought that was the point. You teaching me how to protect myself from it.
Yeah, but I'm not going to shoot lightning at you. If you're lucky, you will never have to use this technique at all.
Well, if you won't help me, I'll find my own lightning.
I think my head is starting to clear out the cactus juice. And look!
Tastes like rotten penguin meat! Oh, I feel woozy.
You've been hallucinating on cactus juice all day, and then you just lick something you find stuck to the wall of a cave?
I have a natural curiosity.
You're sure that's the best way to go?
It's the only way. I mean, it's not like we have Appa to fly us there.
Shush up about Appa. Can't you at least try to be sensitive?
Katara, it's okay.
The baby's coming.
What? Now? Can't you hold it in or something?
Sokka, calm down. I help Grand-Grand deliver lots of babies back home.
This isn't the same as delivering an Arctic seal! This is a real human thing!
It's called a baby, and I helped her deliver plenty of those too.
Good technique, little sister. Keep it up! Don't forget to breathe!
You know, I am just about sick and tired of you telling me what to do all day. You're like a chattering hog monkey.
Just bend the slurry, woman! I just want to say, good effort out there today, Team Avatar.
Enough with the Team Avatar stuff. No matter how many times you say it, it's not gonna catch on.
How about the Boomerang Squad? See, it's good because it's got Aang in it. What are you doing firebending your tea? For a wise old man, that was a pretty stupid move.
I know you're not supposed to cry over spilled tea, but it's just so sad. Would you like a pot of tea?
We've been working in a tea shop all day. I'm sick of tea.
Sick of tea? That's like being sick of breathing. So I was thinking about names for my new tea shop. How about the Jasmine Dragon? It's dramatic, poetic, has a nice ring to it.
The Avatar is here in Ba Sing Se, and he's lost his bison.
We have a chance for a new life here. If you start stirring up trouble, we could lose all the good things that are happening for us.
Good things that are happening for you. Have you ever thought that I want more from life than a nice apartment and a job serving tea?
There's nothing wrong with a life of peace and prosperity. I suggest you think about what it is that you want from your life and why.
I want my destiny.
What that means is up to you. The tea weevil! No, that's stupid.
Maybe Katara could kiss him. That should bring something back.
Maybe you should kiss him, Sokka.
Hey, just an idea.
A bad one.
You're mine now. Uncle?
So, the blue spirit. I wonder who could be behind that mask.
What are you doing here?
I was just about to ask you the same thing. What do you plan to do now that you've found the Avatar's bison? Keep it locked in our new apartment? Should I go put on a pot of tea for him?
First, I have to get it out of here.
And then what? You never think these things through. This is exactly what happened when you captured the Avatar at the North Pole. You had him, and then you had nowhere to go.
I would have figured something out.
No! If his friends hadn't found you, you would have frozen to death.
I know my own destiny, Uncle.
Is it your own destiny? Or is it a destiny someone else has tried to force on you?
Stop it, Uncle. I have to do this.
I'm begging you, Prince Zuko. It's time for you to look inward and begin asking yourself the big questions. Who are you? And what do you want?
Look, we escaped from the Dai Li, we got Appa back. I'm telling you, we should go to the Earth King now and tell him our plan. We're on a roll.
One good hour after weeks of trouble isn't much of a roll.
We can build on it. If we want to invade the Fire Nation when the eclipse happens, we need the Earth King's support.
What makes you think we'll get it? I don't know if you've noticed, but things don't usually go that smoothly for our little gang.
I know, but I've got a good feeling about this. This time will be different.
Sokka, Longfang is in control of the city. His conspiracy with the Dai Li is too powerful. I think we should just keep flying and leave this horrible place behind us.
I'm with Sweetness. I've seen enough of Ba Sing Se.
It's tea time.
Azula!
Have you met the Dai Li? They're earthbenders, but they have a killer instinct that's so firebender. I just love it.
Did I ever tell you how I got the nickname, the Dragon of the West?
I'm not interested in a lengthy anecdote, Uncle.
It's more of a demonstration, really.
Running. It's time I faced Azula.
You're so dramatic. What? Are you going to challenge me to an Agni Kai?
Yes, I challenge you.
No thanks.
Why, Uncle?
You are not the man you used to be, Zuko. You are stronger and wiser and freer than you have ever been. And now you have come to the crossroads of your destiny. It's time for you to choose. It's time for you to choose good.
I expected this kind of treachery from Uncle, but Zuko, Prince Zuko, you're a lot of things, but you're not a traitor. Are you?
Release him immediately.
It's not too late for you, Zuko. You can still redeem yourself.
The kind of redemption she offers is not for you.
Why don't you let him decide, Uncle? I need you, Zuko. I've plotted every move of this day, this glorious day in Fire Nation history, and the only way we win is together. At the end of this day, you will have your honor back. You will have Father's love. You will have everything you want.
Zuko, I am begging you, look into your heart and see what it is that you truly want.
You are free to choose. You seem so downcast. Has May gotten to you already? Though actually, May has been in a strangely good mood lately.
I haven't seen Dad yet. I haven't seen him in 3 years, since I was banished.
So what?
So, I didn't capture the Avatar.
Who cares? The Avatar's dead. Unless you think he somehow miraculously survived.
This is water from the Spirit Oasis at the North Pole. It has special properties, so I've been saving it for something important.
No. There's no way he could have survived.
Well, then I'm sure you have nothing to worry about.
I'll leave you two alone.
What's wrong, Katara?
He left.
What?
Aang. He just took his glider and disappeared. He has this ridiculous notion that he has to save the world alone, that it's all his responsibility.
Maybe that's his way of being brave.
It's not brave, it's selfish and stupid. We could be helping him, and I know the world needs him, but doesn't he know how much that we need him too? How can he just leave us behind?
You're talking about me too, aren't you?
How could you leave us, Dad? I mean, I know we had Gran-Gran and she loved us, but... but we were just so lost without you.
I'm so sorry, Katara.
I understand why you left. I really do. And I know that you had to go. So why do I still feel this way? I'm so sad and angry and hurt.
I love you more than anything. You and your brother are my entire world. I thought about you every day I was gone, and every night when I went to sleep, I would lie awake missing you so much it would ache.
Why'd you do it?
You're going to have to be a little more specific.
Why did you tell Father that I was the one who killed the Avatar?
Can't this wait until morning?
It can't.
Fine. You seemed so worried about how Father would treat you because you hadn't captured the Avatar. I figured if I gave you the credit, you'd have nothing to worry about.
But why?
Call it a generous gesture. I wanted to thank you for your help, and I was happy to share the glory.
You're lying.
If you say so.
You have another motive for doing this. I just haven't figured out what it is.
Please, Zuko. What ulterior motive could I have? What could I possibly gain by letting you get all the glory for defeating the Avatar? Unless, somehow, the Avatar was actually alive, all that glory would suddenly turn to shame and foolishness. But you said yourself that was impossible. Sleep well, Zuzu.
You brought this on yourself, you know. We could have returned together. You could have been a hero. You have no right to judge me, Uncle. I did what I had to do in Ba Sing Se, and you're a fool for not joining me. You're not going to say anything? You're a crazy old man! You're crazy! And if you weren't in jail, you'd be sleeping in a gutter! I brought you some Komodo chicken. I know you don't care for it, but I figure it beats prison food. I admit it, I have everything I always wanted, but it's not at all how I thought it would be. The truth is, I need your advice. I think the Avatar is still alive. I know he's out there. I'm losing my mind. Please, Uncle, I'm so confused. I need your help. Forget it! I'll solve this myself! Waste away in here for all I care!
Army makes their metal there. Moved in a few years ago and started gunking up our river. And now our little village is struggling to survive.
Thanks for the ride.
Look at this place. It's so sad. We have to do something to help.
No, we can't waste our time here. We have a bigger mission that we need to stay focused on. These people are on their own.
These people are starving, but you turn your back on them? How can you be so cold and heartless?
I'm not turning my back. I'm just being realistic. We can't go around helping every rinky-dink town we wander into.
We'll be helping them all by taking out the Fire Lord.
Hey, Loudmouse! Maybe we should be a little quieter when we talk about taking out the Fire Lord.
What's going on?
Fire Nation soldiers are heading to the village.
What did you do?
I kind of destroyed their factory.
You what?
It was your idea.
I was joking. I also said to use spirit magic and made funny noises. Ugh. Did you even think this through? The army's gonna blame the villagers. They're headed there right now to get revenge.
Well, what was I supposed to do?
Leave. Do nothing.
No, I will never, ever turn my back on people who need me. I'm going down to the village. And I am going to do whatever I can.
Wait! I'm coming too.
I thought you didn't want to help.
You need me, and I will never turn my back on you.
Sokka, you really do have a heart.
He really does have a heart, doesn't he?
You sent this, didn't you? I found the secret history. Which, by the way, should be renamed the history most people already know. The note said that I needed to know about my great-grandfather's death, but he was still alive in the end.
No, he wasn't.
What are you talking about?
You have more than one great-grandfather, Prince Zuko. Sozin was your father's grandfather. Your mother's grandfather was Avatar Roku.
Why are you telling me this?
Because understanding the struggle between your two great-grandfathers can help you better understand the battle within yourself. Evil and good are always at war inside you, Zuko. It is your nature, your legacy. But there is a bright side. What happened generations ago can be resolved now by you. Because of your legacy, you alone can cleanse the sins of our family and the Fire Nation. Born in you, along with all the strife, is the power to restore balance to the world. This is a royal artifact. It's supposed to be worn by the Crown Prince.
Dear Katara, sorry for everything, your friend Toph.
I know this is from you, Sokka. Toph can't write. Ugh, you're all driving me crazy!
I can't believe we forgot Toph can't write.
Yep, we're idiots.
That Hama seems a little strange. Like she knows something. Or she's hiding something.
That's ridiculous. She's a nice woman who took us in and gave us a place to stay. She kinda reminds me of Gran-Gran.
But what did she mean by that comment, mysterious children?
Gee, I don't know. Maybe because she found four strange kids camping in the woods at night? Isn't that a little mysterious?
I'm gonna take a look around.
Sokka! Sokka, what are you doing? You can't just snoop around someone's house.
It'll be fine.
He could be home any minute.
Sokka, you're gonna get us all in trouble. And this is just plain rude.
I'm not finished yet.
Come on!
Okay, that's pretty creepy.
So she's got a hobby. There's nothing weird about that. Sokka, you've looked enough. Hama will be back soon.
Just an ordinary puppet-loving innkeeper, huh? Then why does she have a locked door up here?
Probably to keep people like you from snooping through her stuff.
We'll see. It's empty, except for a little chest.
Maybe it's treasure! Sokka, what are you doing? You're breaking into a private room!
I have to see what's in there.
We shouldn't be doing this.
Maybe there's a key here somewhere.
Oh, hand it over.
Come on, come on.
This isn't as easy as it looks.
Guys, I don't know about this. This is crazy. I'm leaving.
Suit yourself. Do it, Toph. I'll tell you what's in the box.
Why are you here?
I'm here to tell the truth.
Telling the truth during the middle of an eclipse. This should be interesting.
First of all, embossing say it was Azula who took down the Avatar, not me.
Why would she lie to me about that?
Because the Avatar's not dead. He survived.
What?
In fact, he's probably leading this invasion. He could be on his way here right now.
Get out! Get out of my sight right now if you know what's good for you.
That's another thing. I'm not taking orders from you anymore.
You will obey me, or this defiant breath will be your last.
Think again. I am going to speak my mind, and you are going to listen. For so long, all I wanted was for you to love me, to accept me. I thought it was my honor that I wanted, but really, I was just trying to please you. You, my father, who banished me just for talking out of turn. My father, who challenged me, a 13-year-old boy, to an Agni Kai. How can you possibly justify a duel with a child?
It was to teach you respect.
It was cruel, and it was wrong.
Then you've learned nothing.
No, I've learned everything. And I've had to learn it on my own. Growing up, we were taught that the Fire Nation was the greatest civilization in history. And somehow, the war was our way of sharing our greatness with the rest of the world. What an amazing lie that was. The people of the world are terrified by the Fire Nation. They don't see our greatness. They hate us. And we deserve it. We've created an era of fear in the world. And if we don't want the world to destroy itself, we need to replace it with an era of peace and kindness.
Your uncle has gotten to you, hasn't he?
Yes, he has. After I leave here today, I'm gonna free Uncle Iroh from his prison, and I'm gonna beg for his forgiveness. He's the one who's been a real father to me.
Oh, that's just beautiful. Maybe he can pass down to you the ways of tea and failure.
But I've come to an even more important decision. I'm going to join the Avatar, and I'm going to help him defeat you.
Really? Since you're a full-blown traitor now and you want me gone, why wait? I'm powerless. You've got your swords. Why don't you just do it now?
Because I know my own destiny. Taking you down is the Avatar's destiny. Goodbye.
Coward! You think you're brave enough to face me, but you'll only do it during the eclipse. If you have any real courage, you'll stick around until the sun comes out. Don't you want to know what happened to your mother?
What happened that night?
My father, Fire Lord Azulon, had commanded me to do the unthinkable to you, my own son. And I was going to do it. Your mother found out and swore she would protect you at any cost. She knew I wanted the throne, and she proposed a plan in which I would become Fire Lord and your life would be spared.
Where's Suki? Answer me!
Sokka, she won't talk.
Where are you keeping her?
Your mother did vicious, treasonous things that night. She knew the consequences and accepted them. For her treason, she was banished.
So she's alive.
Perhaps. Now I realize that banishment is far too merciful a penalty for treason. Your penalty will be far steeper.
Thank you.
around to attack us again.
They're headed for the beach. They're gonna destroy the submarines!
How are we all gonna escape?
We're not.
Then our only choice is to stand and fight. We have the Avatar. We could still win.
Yes, with the Avatar, we could still win. On another day. You kids have to leave. You have to escape on Appa together.
What? We can't leave you behind. We won't leave anyone behind.
You're our only chance in the long run. You and Sokka have to go with Aang somewhere safe. It's the only way to keep hope alive.
The youngest of our group should go with you. The adults will stay behind and surrender. We'll be prisoners, but we'll all survive this battle.
I've got some experience with Fire Nation prisons. It's not going to be easy, but we'll get by.
They're at the beach already!
What a stunning view.
The only view I'm interested in seeing is the Avatar in chains.
You know, the Avatar hasn't been seen for 100 years. The chances of finding him here are very slim.
First, we'll check each of the air temples. Then we'll scour the world, searching even the most remote locations until we find him.
Prince Zuko, it's only been a week since your banishment. You should take some time to heal and rest.
What else would I expect to hear from the laziest man in the Fire Nation? The only way to regain my honor is to find the Avatar. So I will. That's a problem. It's my sister and her friend.
This is a rematch I've been waiting for.
Me too.
If we cut the line, there's no way he'll survive.
He knows that. They're cutting the line. The gondola's about to go.
I hope this thing floats.
What are you doing?
Saving the jerk who dumped me.
It's May.
What is she doing?
Sorry, Warden. Your record is officially broken.
Well, we made it out. Now what?
Zuko, what are you doing?
My sister was on that island.
Yeah, and she's probably right behind us, so let's not stop.
What I mean is she must have come here somehow. There! That's our way out of here. What are you doing here?
You mean it's not obvious yet? I am about to celebrate becoming an only child!
Yun-Ra! You lazy piece of work! I need something!
Yes, Mother. What is it?
The tomato carrots from your garden are too hard for my gums! I need something soft and juicy!
Would you like something else from the garden? I would be happy to...
Forget your stupid garden! Get your grimy hiney to the market and buy me some real food!
Sorry I'm late, Father. Good palanquin bearers are so hard to come by these days. So, is everything ready for our departure?
There has been a change of plans, Azula.
What?
I've decided to lead the fleet of airships to Ba Sing Se alone. You will remain here in the Fire Nation.
But I thought we were going to do this together.
My decision is final.
You can't treat me like this. You can't treat me like Zuko!
Azula, silence yourself.
But it was my idea to burn everything to the ground. I deserve to be by your side.
Azula!
All right, Hare. It's time to face your doom.
What a shame. You always had such beautiful hair.
What are you doing here?
I didn't want to miss my own daughter's coronation.
Don't pretend to act proud. I know what you really think of me. You think I'm a monster.
I think you're confused. All your life you've used fear to control people, like your friends May and Ty Lee.
Well, what choice do I have? Trust is for fools. Fear is the only reliable way.
even you fear me.
No, I love you, Azula. I do.
Sorry, but you're not going to become Fire Lord today. I am.
You're hilarious.
And you're going down.
Wait.
You want to be Fire Lord?
Fine.
Let's settle this. Just you and me, brother. The showdown that was always meant to be. Agni Kai!
You're on.
What are you doing? She's playing you. She knows she can't take us both, so she's trying to separate us.
I know. But I can take her this time.
But even you admitted to your uncle that you would need help facing Azula.
There's something off about her. I can't explain it, but she's slipping. And this way, no one else has to get hurt.
I'm sorry it has to end this way, brother.
No, you're not. What's the matter? Afraid I'll redirect it?
Oh, I'll show you lightning!
I should count myself lucky. The new Fire Lord has graced me with his presence in my lowly prison cell.
You should count yourself lucky that the Avatar spared your life. Banishing me was the best thing you could have done for my life. It put me on the right path. Perhaps your time in here can do the same for you.
Why are you really here?
Because you're going to tell me something. Where is my mother?